Good evening, YouTube. This is about 7:30, Friday evening, August 24th, 2012. And before it got dark, I thought I'd run up here and take a little look at the garden. I've been real busy today and hadn't had time to get up here today at all. It rained late yesterday afternoon a good bit. So I want to take a look at it before I got busy for the weekend. And we're up here on the upper end of the garden. This is the Puerto Rican sweet potatoes. And you can see they're really flourishing. They've done really well, filled out all the area. Look what the rabbits did. Now, if they could get into my garden now, that's what they would be doing. These are the vines that have come through the rabbit fencing. And you can see where they... On some of them, they even ate the ends of the vines off. And that's how they did the first year, 3 years ago. They completely ate the vines up to the ground where they emerged from the ground. So I know that if they could get in, that's what they would be doing. So I'm very thankful to have my my rabbit fencing up. These are the zipper cream peas. They have been going gangbusters. I've gotten almost 5 bushels off of these 350-foot rows. And they've just finishing up their fourth bloom. And as you can see, I will probably have to pick in another day or so. They are just loaded. They're really just filled out. A lot of bloom still coming out on it. You can see on the bloom nodes, they are getting ready to throw out another crop of blooms. I mean, all you got to do is just check those little stalks, and you can see the next set of blooms getting ready to emerge. These are the peas that just won't stop. Really, since I've had water on my garden has done that all this year. You can see there is probably a good bushel that is coming on, probably nearly 2 bushels, getting ready to come on this garden. These zipper creams, I'm sorry. They're just loaded. Really loaded. A lot of baby ones. There's some tiny ones. Young ones coming on. Some that probably could be picked right now. That's nice and fat and filled out. Yeah, they're about ready. After 3 failed attempts at green beans this year, I have a very nice stand. The first three was eaten up by the rabbits, and one of those three, it got a little wet, and I think a combination of heat probably made it get the root rot or get rot at the roots, whatever it was. But I have a very nice stand of contender bush beans now, and I'm very pleased. They're filled out. They all came up. No big old skips in there. And so looks like the heat has let up a lot here. It's only getting up in about the mid-80s now. Then we're getting plenty of rain. And so got a good crop of green beans coming on. I have one 90-foot row of Clemson spineless okra, and I just discovered the other day, let's see if I can find it now, they actually have the little things coming up there for the blooms, so I look for them to be blooming here. Probably I'd say let's give them a week and a half. You can see down in there the little bloom pods have formed. So, looking forward to having some okra here. I'd say probably in 3 weeks or less, we should be cutting some okra. It's a little shorter down on this end. I guess because this was newer ground, I did extend the garden about 10 feet when I put the irrigation down because I wanted longer rows. Here's a little 9 or 10 foot portion of a row, and I have garlic. It's not real obvious, but I have about 42 garlic planted in there, and you can see I staggered them. They're about 4 or 5 inches apart from here to here, but just about every one of them are up. That's probably about 9 inches tall there. Some of them a little shorter. And my Envy soybeans are blooming. They're full of blooms. You can see the little blue blooms down in there. They were more full the other day, but I didn't get a chance to, let's see here. Well, it's not showing it really good in this late evening sun. Maybe you can see these there, all the way down on there. But these are the edamame type soybeans. I've already set out, and it's probably not very evident. I think I have a row here of beets. I just planted those yesterday morning or day before yesterday morning, so they, of course, have not germinated and emerged yet. And my little cabbage and cauliflower, they're tiny. They're just coming up. Are up. One lone sweet banana plant, and he's so full, he's fell over to the ground. He doesn't have anybody to hold him up. Poor thing. There's some of the little cabbage and rutabagas and cauliflower and broccoli and all that. Here's a few heels. I have about 9 or 10 heels of, it looks like this heel here died. I don't know what's going on there. That looks like it died. But I still have plenty of those, of yellow prolific squash. And I have about 9 heels. Oh, we got balloons. Those will probably bloom tomorrow. This is my Fort Hook zucchinis. Got a couple of them old Talladega tomato plants left, but I think they're on their last leg. They got a few green ones on there, though. This is the pink eye purple hulls. We've already picked 2 bushel off of these. They don't look like they're as quick to rebound to bloom. Let's see. Looks like they are trying to get ready to kick back out, but they're not as quick to respond, it looks like. These 6 eggplants are still going, but they're looking mighty pitiful. Still a few eggplant hanging up in under there. We're just so tired of them, we just don't even bother with them now. We've given them away. People are saying, oh, don't bring me any more. So apparently there is a limit to what people can eat of eggplant. these pink eyes are doing really well. This row is taller and more viney. Probably throwed out a little too much horse manure, and they're under this about 80-foot pine tree to about 11 o'clock during the day, and so yeah, it's got 2 counts against it, it looks like. They're real tall, and the other rows over there are real short. But they're still putting out. I mean, they still loaded with beans and all. But they're a little later than the other ones. You can see a lot of peas up in there. They're just a little bit slower getting ready than the other ones. I still have these few Big Dipper plants up in here. They've never really done well for me. They did put on a lot of pepper, but they stay real little, real little. But it's given me what I've needed to do my chow chows and relishes and all, and I need a few more. I've got pear relish coming up that I want to do. Family is clamoring for that. But I may be able to use these cubanelles. I love the cubanelles. They're very prolific. They don't have a single Scoville of heat, and they're sweet, but they have all the flavor of those really hot peppers, but not a Scoville of heat in them. They're just as sweet as the green peppers. I baked a few the other day. I parboiled them for a few minutes, split them and seeded them, and stuffed them with some cornbread stuffing and sauteed some onions and tomatoes, some green tomatoes and eggplant and a couple of these little cubanelle peppers, and put that in it and put all that together and popped it in the stove and put a little bit of marinara over them. Oh man, the family went crazy over it. It was really delicious. Well, it's getting late on me here. Yeah, these cubanelles, I want to say, are doing really well. They seem to really be loving the shade. Of course, the peas have gotten over on them. But they like that shade. They like the heat and they like the water. Look at that nice one there. Boy, he's really big. But they're hanging all up under there. Full. Anywhere you pull it back, you just see them all up in there. Well, that winds it up for this afternoon. I want to keep this short, not be so wordy. Hope y'all having a good weekend. Gonna have a good weekend. This is Friday evening, and weather's starting to cool off a little bit. I've noticed these shadows are really getting long in the evening early. And here it is now. In this area, the sun will set tonight at 7:58. So I guess we won't see 8 o'clock sunsets anymore the rest of this year. But garden's really doing well. Those rows that look like they're empty, they're all planted. I still need room for carrots and radishes, some of my lettuce. But all that can't go in until I rip all these beans up, these peas up, and I really want to get as many peas off of them as I can. And I thought I was going to pull these zipper creams up, and then they went to blooming like mad again. And so here I am still letting them stay in. I mean, you see how beautiful they look. There's not a sick plant in there. And so while they're willing and able to put out the peas, I'm just going to leave them, try to get as many peas out of them as I can, and pretty soon the okra will be coming on in a couple more weeks, and I can can up some more okra. Anyway, that's it for tonight. Thank you for taking the tour with me, and we'll be talking with you later. Bye now.